As we bring you this broadcast here on India Today, there are dramatic developing scenes playing out at the Delhi-Uttar Pradesh border in Ghazipur, which is one of the three main border points where the farmer protests have been taking place for over 2 months. The protesting farmers have been asked to end their protests and vacate the roads by the administration. However, Bharatiya Kisan Union leader Rakesh Tikait, the man who's become in many ways the face of this protest, and the man who's been leading the stir at Ghazipur, is still defiant and has refused to leave the stir site and has sat on a hunger strike. Earlier addressing his supporters, he urged the police to find the real culprits of the violence of what he says, which unfolded on Republic Day in Delhi. Remember, this even though Rakesh Tikait himself has been caught on camera saying some very questionable things to the agitators before Republic Day. Remember, farmer leaders including Tikait have been named in FIRs filed by the Delhi police, which showed remarkable restraint in the face of the violence that was perpetrated by agitators on Republic Day in connection with the violence during Tuesday's so-called tractor rally, when it was really just a murderous rampage in many ways. Sources have told India Today that the Ghaziabad administration have given an ultimatum to the farmers to vacate the roads by tonight. Ghaziabad district magistrate and senior police officers are engaging with farmers amidst a heavy deployment of police and paramilitary forces. All roads leading to Ghazipur have been blocked by the police. To put this into perspective, ladies and gentlemen, remember, for the last 62 days, this particular protest site, these three protest sites, have had a complete free-for-all. It was a peaceful protest, and therefore the farmer agitators were allowed to collect there in large numbers at enormous inconvenience to local businesses, local citizens, petrol pumps, shops, offices, etc. But the farmers refused to move from the site, even though they were invited to go to the Ramlila Maidan or another protest venue, which would not be an inconvenience to other common citizens of the country. It is only after the Republic Day violence that you're seeing this large deployment of paramilitary and police, because the farmer agitators, or so-called agitators, have shown that they are capable of murderous violence that they now stand charged with.
मेरे किसान को मारने की कोशिश करी जा रही है, ये साजिश है, मारने की साजिश बीजेपी के लोग कर रहे हैं। यहाँ पर जितने यहाँ पर लोग हैं, उनके मारने की साजिश रची जा रही। बीजेपी के विधायक यहाँ पे हैं, उनके 300 लोग यहाँ पे हैं, लाठी डंडे और गोलियों से मौजूद हैं। यहाँ के पुलिस प्रशासन 2000 पुलिस के लोग यहाँ पे मौजूद है। ये अत्याचार है किसान के साथ में, देश के किसान के साथ में गद्दारी है, किसान के साथ में धोखा हो
जाए। आगे क्या
कानून वापसी हो गए जिस कोच के लिए आए हैं, यहाँ से आंदोलन जारी रहेगा, आंदोलन जारी होगा, आंदोलन जारी रहेगा। इसका किसान ये 5 लाख टैक्स है, मेरी जिम्मेदारी है, इस किसान की मेरी जिम्मेदारी है, इस किसान को बर्बादी होने दूंगा देश के।
आज अचानक क्या हुआ पूरा घटनाक्रम बताइए।
बीजेपी पार्टी लगी सारी किसान को बर्बाद करने लगी, नहीं छोड़ने को। ये बिल भी वापसी होंगे। अगर बिल वापसी नहीं हुए, अगर कानून वापसी नहीं होंगे, तो राकेश टिकैत आत्महत्या
करेगा।
तारी नहीं, वो स्थल अवैध है। 133 के तहत पब्लिक न्यूसेंस है, रोड बंद हो गया है, आप जान रहे हो, ये नोटिस सर्व हुआ है, इसके बाद वो विचार करके हमको बताएंगे।
देखिए सर, हम तो अपने कर्तव्य का निर्वहन जो है ना, शुरू से करते आए हैं। कल भी किया था, आज भी किया और कल भी करेंगे। हम अपना कर्तव्य निभाने में कोई कसर नहीं छोड़ेंगे, और शांति, सेवा और न्याय दिल्ली पुलिस का हमारा मोटो है, उस पर अटल है। उसके लिए अगर हमें अपनी जान देनी पड़े तो हम अपनी जान भी कुर्बान करेंगे।
लेकिन एक किसान जो बैठे हुए हैं, आंदोलनकारी जो बैठे हैं, आप लोग बार बार ये कह रहे हैं कि खाली करो आज, और डीएम ने भी कहा है, तो आपको लगता है आज खाली हो जाएगा ये?
हमें अपने पॉइंट पर जो है टाइमली ड्यूटी पे बुलाया गया है, जो कार्रवाई करने के लिए हमें आदेश मिलेंगे, हम उसका संपूर्ण और स्वागत करके उसका कार्य करेंगे।
अगर वो आराम से खाली नहीं करेंगे तो फोर्सफुली भी खाली कराया जाएगा।
ये ही एरिया है और मुझे नहीं लगता कि ऐसा कुछ जरूरत पड़ेगी। वो भी शांति का ही है और मार्ग अपनाएंगे और हम भी शांति से उनके साथ सहयोग करेंगे।
नहीं, आप कह रहे थे कि इनको खाली कर देना चाहिए, बहुत दिनों से लोगों को असुविधा हो रही है।
नहीं, बट नेचुरल है, क्योंकि जान माल का नुकसान वो हमने अभी पीछे बचाया है। हमने खुद पत्थर खाए, हमने विश्वासघात इनका वो झेला। इन्होंने म्यूचुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग करके समय का पालन नहीं किया, स्थान का पालन नहीं किया, इन्होंने हर वो चीज़ वायलेट की जो इनको नहीं करनी चाहिए थी। तो हमें लगता है कि इनका जो गंतव्य जो मंतव्य था वो सही दिशा की तरफ मार्गदर्शित नहीं है और इनको अपनी मॉरल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी समझ के नैतिक जिम्मेदारी ये लेते हुए इनके नेतृत्व का फेलियर है। इन नेतृत्व को
Okay, I want to quickly take you across live to the border points where all these developments are playing out right now. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, this is still a developing story. The police is there. They're talking to the farmer leaders and the protest. Rakesh Tiket has sat on protest. Ankit Tyagi and Shivendra Srivastav are with me live from the Ghazipur border. Mausimi is at the Singhu border. These are the two nerve centers of a protest that in many ways has lost some of his strength since the violence on Republic Day. Ankit, to you first. Rakesh Tiket, after a very emotional outburst, you know, a threatening suicide and saying that he will not call off his stir, has now gone on an Anna Hazare style fast unto death. Is that what the latest is, Ankit?
That's right, Shiv. You are right. Rakesh Tiket, quite an emotional Rakesh Tiket. Usually we have seen a belligerent, confident Rakesh Tiket, a complete opposite picture today because of the kind of pressure that has been put by the administration right now. In Uttar Pradesh, one thing is very clear. The government has decided they are going to remove whatever border sites are there, and they are also bolstered by the fact that at Ghazipur border, where I have been coming for the last couple of months, the numbers today are not as many as we have seen usually. We need to understand and make a differentiation that in the last 3 to 4 days, a lot of people had come only for 26 January. But the usual Ghazipur crowd also not here today. The numbers are less, and possibly that is what the opportunity that the administration senses in trying to, in fact, remove this entire protest site, which has been blocking one of the roads, one of the lanes of the national highway right now where I'm standing. I just want to show you, Shiv, one side is the massive police contingent. And, you know, usually when you come here in the last couple of months, you have never seen the police stepping up and in big numbers going right in front of the stage, which is just behind me, that side. Now, Rakesh Tiket is up there. He says that initially he had agreed to court arrest. He said that that was on one condition, that the protest site would not be dismantled, that the farmers, there will be no high-handedness of the police as far as the farmers are concerned. The police now say they have clear orders to, in fact, make sure this entire protest site is vacated and the traffic is normalized on both sides. As we speak, both the road coming from Delhi and going to Delhi has been blocked by the Delhi police and the Uttar Pradesh police. Delhi police fears that if there is forceful removal, many of these farmers might try and make their dash towards Delhi and try and reach Singhu or Tikri border. They are preventing that. The Uttar Pradesh police does not want any other farmers to, in fact, come and join them from where I'm standing. So all the remaining farmers, both on the flyover and under the flyover, have been asked by the farmer leaders to assemble near this stage. Now, this will become the main focal point. I'll just show you. The farmers have started coming out of their tents, whatever number is left, and all of them are now with their bunks, with their mattresses, and in fact, their quilts sitting under the open sky. They are trying to consolidate their position around the tent. But Shiv, it does look like with the kind of orders and the determination the administration is standing here today, possibly they would try and clear this entire thing. I have been told that the time have been given to them for midnight tonight. If the protest site is not cleared, possibly force would be used.
Okay, so there is a concrete ultimatum that has been laid down. Ankit Tyagi reporting that by midnight tonight, if things are not cleared up, as has been instructed by the UP government, then you know, one wonders, what, maybe it's going to be a forcible eviction, and we all know what that could lead to. We've got a quick update. I just want to show you that we've got the biggest team of reporters reporting from the border, so they're going to tell you what's happening. But here's the latest. Two more farmer unions have quit the protest at Delhi borders, the BKU Lok Shakti and the BKU Ekta. As you can see, the Bharat Kisan Union has many factions. The BKU Lok Shakti and the BKU Ekta have now called off their protest. This is after a couple of other unions have also, smaller unions have quit the protest at this time. This is shortly after the Republic Day violence and after charges have been framed against many farm union leaders. A total of 5 farmer unions have now officially quit this agitation on the back of what happened on Republic Day. I want to quickly go across to Mousmi Singh, who's with us at the Singhu border, the other nerve center of these protests. Mousmi, 5 unions have now pulled out. It's still a small number compared to the number of unions, and there are much larger ones which are still there. Rakesh Tikait's union organization, still one of the largest, and he's just made it very clear that he's going to sit in on a hunger protest. What is the scene at Singhu, Mousmi? Because visibly things look different today.
Shiv, India Today has been on ground zero covering this marathon agitation.
Yes.
From day one. And we've been here reporting each and every detail, covering the human interest stories, covering the stories of unity and solidarity. And especially at Singhu, it was one of the biggest nerve centers. We saw a triumph of spirits, a triumph over all the hardships, the biting cold. But just on the fateful day, the 26th of January, as events have turned violent, we've seen a lull after what happened on the 26th of January at the Singhu border. We were here yesterday also till midnight, and we saw that there was a calm that was prevailing. No loudspeaker announcements, no singing, no chanting, and the followers, the crowd was far less. That's a fact that we saw while we were reporting from ground zero. And right now I can tell you, even as the farmers keep a close watch at what's happening at the Ghazipur border, at the Singhu border, we've seen a lot of vehicular movement of police vehicles, change of duties, increase in the security personnels that are deployed here, especially the women force. Remember, at the Singhu border, we've got a whole lot strength of women farmers who are sitting in protest with children. So we've seen that there is a lot of deployment of women force here at the Singhu border.
Okay.
And this barricade, which you see, we are not stationed anywhere close to the stage. The barricade has been moved up on the national highway, about a 3-kilometer stretch. Now it's cordoned off at the periphery of the Singhu border.
Okay.
Even as the farmers are waiting to see what happens at Ghazipur.
This is a developing story. Mousmi, continue to stay with me. I want to quickly get our viewers an update that's just coming in right now. This is an update on the case, the investigation so far. Encounter specialist, Delhi Police Special ACP Lalit Mohan Negi has been named the investigating officer of the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act investigation, which will probe the Red Fort incident and the conspiracy hatched for the violence that was perpetrated at ITO and at Red Fort during the tractor rally on Republic Day. So a prominent police officer has been named the investigating officer in this. I want to welcome onto our show, we have Nupur Sharma of the BJP, we have Supriya Srinath of the Congress. Welcome to you both. But before I go to the both of them, I just want to quickly get in a word from India Today's Shivendra Srivastav, who is at the Ghazipur border. He also tracks the UP government that has just issued an ultimatum, as Ankit was reporting, that the protesters need to move by midnight or else. Shivendra, what is the plan? What is the district magistrate, the police's plan in case the protesters don't move by midnight?
See, there are clear instructions from CM Yogi Adityanath that like this place should be vacated today itself. That's why senior police officials from UP police and administrator is also present here at the spot. In the meantime, after failed talk between administrators, Security is beefed up. All the roads are blocked by the police and RAF jawans here. You can see RAF jawans are deployed here with tear gas and other protective gears as well. If something goes wrong and protesters come on this side, they can handle it very well. That's why they are being deployed here. This thing is very clear that government has given instruction that these farmers should be removed today itself. That's why they are beefing up security and calling in several troops of police as well. Now, situation is this, that Rakesh Tikait is saying that he will not call off this station, and administration is talking to Rakesh Tikait for like ending this protest at this Ghazipur border.
Okay.
But it seems that nothing going to be happen positively, because these troops are deployed here, and they are instructed if something goes wrong, they should handle it. And in the meantime, notice is being served to Rakesh Tikait for giving answer in 3 days. And also, there are lots of other ways tried to handle the situation, but it seems something.
No. So basically, it's a difficult situation. I hear what you're saying, Shivendra. It's a difficult situation because there is limited time. There is a case running. And you've now got Rakesh Tikait sitting on this hunger strike, which I'm sure must have been anticipated by the authorities as well, because this has been an unpredictable sort of protest, especially in the hours after what happened on Republic Day. Stay with me. Quick bit of another update coming in. Lots of updates, lots of breaking news coming in this evening, because this is a dynamic story. Farmers groups have decided to file a petition against this order from the Ghaziabad administration to vacate the protest site by tonight. They are saying that even the Supreme Court has approved their peaceful protest, hence this order is illegal. The Ghaziabad District Magistrate has issued an ultimatum that the farmers need to move from Ghazipur by the end of today. By midnight, they need to move from there, but the farmers have said that they will be filing a petition against this order. Abhishek Anand is with me for a quick update on this. Abhishek, they're going to file a petition. Where are they filing this petition, and what kind of relief are they hoping for, given that this is an ultimatum, until midnight tonight? There's very little time.
Well, Shiv, the farmer union leaders are claiming that the Supreme Court has granted them permission to stay at the protest site, which is actually not a permission from the court. The court didn't object their presence at the protest site, claiming that that every person has a right for peaceful protest. But at the same time, this is the jurisdiction of the district magistrate, and the magistrate has full rights to take action against anybody who he feels that is threatening the peace in the area. Now the farmers are planning to go to the court, but the ultimatum is for tonight. And this is the farmer leaders are now vying to reach court and to get some kind of relief so that they should not be removed from there.
Okay. You know, in a country like India, especially when there are large protests of this kind, you can never really predict the way things are going. But Nupur Sharma, what is it looking like right now? The Delhi police is there. They've shown remarkable restraint over the Republic Day violence. Now it appears that the law is taking its course. Cases have been filed. Summons have been served. Show cause notices have been given to the farmer leaders, but you've got a situation where Rakesh Tikait, who's become the face of this agitation, as it were, is sitting on a hunger protest, Nupur.
Well, good evening, Shiv, to you, the co-panelists, correspondents, and obviously to all viewers watching this show. I don't know what to say. I mean, all due respect to Mr. Tikait's father. He happens to belong to the same area as my maternal side of family. And I must say that, you know, we actually took whatever he said and whatever he stood for in good stride. We decided to, put our faith in all these, I would say now, so-called farm leaders, irrespective of the fact that Mr. Tikait himself was a contestant from an opposition party in the last Lok Sabha elections. But can you actually, not pay attention to statements that he made today twice? Hindi mein usko kehte hain uksana. The kind of desperation of a doopta jahaj saying, goli maro hamare ko, goli maro, gundai philae ja rahi hai. Whereas all the gundai that you could ever hear in words, in spoken words, were coming from Mr. Tikait's mic. And can you also actually overlook his statements like किसी के बाप की जागीर है दिल्ली? कौन रोकेगा हमारे को? दिल्ली खबरदार, कौन रोकेगा ट्रैक्टर रैली को? किसकी औकात है? I mean, and so on and so forth. I have it all written down. You know, all that his father ever stood for, all the goodwill that his father actually ever earned in his life, has all been undone by Mr. Rakesh Tikait's antics.
Okay.
And whatever the entire farm protest culminated in. Into on January 26th.
But, you know, Srinath,
our politicians are actually not getting
for, you know, the
I came across, just one sentence.
Yes, yes.
Just one sentence. I cannot overlook the statement made by Rahul Gandhi of Congress Party today. He said, "Pure desh mein aag lag jayegi." What does he mean by that?
Okay.
What
okay.
does he mean by that?
We'll go to what Rahul Gandhi said in a moment. I just want to dwell first on Rakesh Tikait. Supriya Srinath, you know, would you agree that Rakesh Tikait has lost a lot of his standing after the events of the last 48 hours? He's gotten very emotional now. He's playing a little bit of victim. But there is evidence that he certainly did instigate what's going on. He is cornered now. Is there anything left to stand on?
You know, I'm not a spokesperson for Rakesh Tikait, and neither am I going to do a ball-by-ball commentary on what he has said or not. You know, he was leading this protest. He is going to now be answerable for whatever he said or not said. But I really want to place on record before anything else, because for all of us, including my co-panelists from the BJP, we're all in public life, and at no level can we endorse the fact that this violence happened on Republic Day. And when you say the law is catching up, I really wish the law catches up with the likes of Deep Sidhu. He's still at large. It's been 48 hours since that fateful event happened at the Red Fort. It is a national monument. There is no other place other than the tricolor. That man is still at large.
But he's been named in the FIR. That's a developing story,
Supriya. He may have been named in the FIR, Shiv. He may have been named in the FIR, Shiv. But if you may allow me to quote something in Hindi, agar police chah jaye, toh mohalle ke mandir ki chappal chori nahi hoti hai.
I hear what you're saying. I hear what you're saying. But there are so many others as well. Nobody has been.
What is happening?
Very few people have been detained so far, ma'am. You know, see, the thing is, this will get caught in that unending spiral. You'll have Bhalla's pictures put up. You know, now Nupur will show pictures of Bhalla with Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi. Then it will become some people were with Congress, some people were with BJP. There's an investigation now. I'm talking about. I appreciate the point both of you are making. See, Nupur's got a phone poked at the camera as well. I'm just saying we're talking about whether the farmer protests have been fatally damaged by what has happened. Because ultimately, after 2 months of a largely peaceful protest, where there wasn't really much of a big security deployment there stopping the farmers from protesting there, this one day of violence has completely ended it. You've seen what's happened in the last 10 hours. Nupur,
if you may allow me to speak now.
Yeah, okay. Shiv, quickly make your point, then I'll... Then, yeah.
Yeah, because Shiv, you know, you did not intervene when my co-panelist was talking.
Supriya, forgive me. I was just saying, let's not get into the Bhalla versus Deep Sidhu thing. That's a separate thing. We've been doing that all day today.
I am not getting into anybody, but I think this also needs to be placed on record.
100%. It's been on record all day on India Today.
Yes, so please, I mean, if it's my chance to speak, I'm not going to watch India Today every day and say what's playing on record. My simple point with this whole thing is, what led to what we are witnessing today? For 63 days, these farmers were protesting in the most peaceful way. Did you report one untoward incident? None. What happened is something that merits a judicial inquiry.
So
it merits a full-fledged inquiry. What happened? What went wrong? Who infiltrated this movement? And if there was prior intelligence reports, which is now being claimed, then why was no action taken? Why were these rowdy elements not weeded out? Is that not a valid point to ask?
No, it's...
Because this is a great security breach in the last 1 year alone in the capital city of Delhi. Delhi riots and now this.
You know, all of these... My limited point here, I'll get Mr. Kakaran after Nupur, but my limited point here is, of course, these are valid questions that need to be asked, but I'm just saying the investigation has just begun. It's just begun. I mean, the summons have just been issued to some of these players. You know, some of them have blamed each other. Some of them have pulled out of the protest.
Why did the police not act?
No, but
I think that's a very valid question to ask.
The questions for the Delhi police are certainly questions that we will continue to ask, but that's a separate debate. Intelligence failure, whether too much leniency was shown, whether they were lured to discredit themselves are all questions. Believe me, we ask all questions here on India Today. Don't worry about that, Supriya. But Nupur, you want to respond to what she's saying? We need to get to the root of it.
Isse fayda kiska ho raha hai? Just ask that question.
Okay, now...
Specifics, Nupur.
For the questions asked.
Yeah.
Now to sit here and to say what action was taken. Yes, specifically. Well, she would certainly know. She's been previously a journalist. It is not for the police to adjudicate. It is for the police to investigate and collect evidence to show and submit to the courts. Now, if she doesn't remember, wasn't Deep Sidhu actually summoned by the NIA? Of course, that he chose not to appear before the NIA for interrogation is completely now another added evidence against him. But let's not forget, I was not showing Nikhil Bhalla. I was showing Himachal Congress Sevadal verified Twitter handle on 20 November 2020 calling Deep Sidhu voice of a farmer by uploading a video. It still exists on their verified handle. Now, having said that, of course, Deep Sidhu himself has said to a senior female journalist, I have nothing to do with the BJP. I don't believe in them. And we also, Sunny Deol has also gone on record. Nikhil Bhalla, obviously, nobody in the Congress has an answer for that.
See,
but I have something else to say. It is recorded evidence, allow me, it is recorded evidence that Bhindranwale literature was actually... single border. It is recorded evidence by nobody else but the All India Congress Committee, Kisan Congress National Joint Convener, Mr. Gursimran Singh Mann, in December 2020 to the STF in Haryana, that Khalistanis have infested and SFJ has infested this very protest. Now, what the police is doing is investigating. Now, you name one certain and one single case as a journalist from your memory, if you may remember, any kind of investigation which is ongoing, because it also culminated into January 26th
memory serves me right.
This has already happened.
My memory serves me right.
And the courts have also adjudicated overnight that, you know, here is the guilty person and here is the one who's acquitted. Now, I also want to come back to the Congress Party. Please explain Mr. Nikhil Bhalla's role by profession. He's an advocate. What is he doing atop a tractor at ITO, wherein tractors were attempting to run down not only
those pictures are on our screen, as were the pictures. Supriya, the pictures of Deep Sidhu that you were talking about were on the screen when you were talking about him. The pictures of Nikhil Bhalla with the Congress leaders are now on your screen. Answer that.
Just one point to ask.
Yeah, no, since you invoked the Deep Sidhu thing, I told you the Nikhil Bhalla thing would be invoked. Now answer that.
No, I will just ask one question. You know, it's all good for us to discuss what happened on the 26th. Do we as a civilized society and people in public life also need to discuss what led to this? For 63 days, those farmers were protesting peacefully.
But
look
Supriya,
at the Supriya, my the way fact of highway of this government.
Supriya, the fact that we're discussing what is happening now does not mean we're not asking those questions.
You're calling it peaceful.
I hope you will, you will extend me the
but
same
I have a question.
I did not intervene when you were.
Nupur, I'll give you time. Let her finish.
You
let her finish.
Keep talking.
I'm sorry.
We're both. These are Skype connections, so it's disrupting the audio. Nupur, one second. Let her finish. I'll come to you. I'll give you time. Let her finish. Otherwise, the audio can't be heard.
I don't do debates where people talk over each other.
No, Supriya, please continue.
I don't do debate. So I did not speak while she was speaking.
Continue.
I'm not going to allow someone to speak between me as well. I have a simple point to ask. These farmers were protesting peacefully. They don't want these laws. They're not against reforms. They are saying repeal these laws, sit and discuss with us, and then bring in new laws. Why is the government so obstinate? And why does every movement in this country, every voice of protest in this country...
You've zoomed out to a bigger question, Supriya. We have a limited time. We're talking about something specific now.
Let me answer that in 5 seconds.
Please tell me. No, you please answer this question.
Let me answer that pointed question in 5 seconds. Two sentences, 5 seconds. That's all I'll take.
Gets degenerated into anti-national.
5 seconds and I want to give my viewers a report. 5 seconds, I'll give my viewers a report of that.
If everybody's anti-national...
Hold on. Supriya, okay, Supriya, you've had your time. Supriya, let Nupur answer that. You've asked a question. You've said, you've asked her a specific question. Let her answer that. Give her a moment to answer you. Nupur, go ahead.
This is an interesting bit of intervention where pot is calling the kettle black.
You are venting the entire farming community.
Supriya, one second. You had your chance. Supriya, one second.
I'm sorry.
Supriya, one second.
I should be given a free hand.
Supriya, our viewers can't hear the both of you. Let Nupur answer you now. If there's time, I'll give you time again. Yes, Nupur.
Suddenly she can't be pontificating, especially when her intervention, you know, at best sounds like the pot calling the kettle black. For that party, when it's in its manifest in 2019, promised to do away with the mandi system, 2010-2011 agriculture minister's letter.
I'm sorry, it was the greatest security.
Supriya, no interruptions, come on.
Please, no talking over each other.
This is okay.
I will let her for the rest of the debate.
Supriya, let Nupur make her point. Let's try and make this as substantive as possible. Finish your point, Nupur.
She has to offer it. I'm sorry, Shiv. I have a free hand to heckle her throughout this debate. For the remaining bit, I will heckle her. Because she does not follow what she
says. I'll give the both of you a breather for a moment. I'll give the both of you a breather for just a minute when I get my viewers a report right now, and then I'm going to come back to our guests. We also have T.R. Kakkar, former Delhi Police Commissioner. Not just at Ghazipur, the situation through the day was tense at the other border sites as well. At the Singhu border, locals erupted in anger against protesters, asking them to vacate the highway. I'm talking about locals, people who live around that area from away as well, who've all collected there to protest against the farmers. Meanwhile, 37 farmer leaders have been booked for allegedly instigating Republic Day violence. Some of the charges that they face include conspiracy and attempt to murder.
Tension, sloganeering, heavy police deployment at Delhi borders. Anger is rising over the months-long blockade of highways by farmers protesting against the new farm laws. A group of locals took out a march at Singhu border. They wanted the farmers to vacate the arterial roads.
पुलिस वाले हमारे भाई हमारी सुरक्षा में उनको मारा इन्होंने वह किसान नहीं कर सकता ये बेटे कर सकते हैं हम बॉर्डर खाली कराएंगे हम दिल्ली पुलिस के साथ हैं
वन साइड देयर इज अ स्टेज वेयर फार्मर्स आर प्रोटेस्टिंग एंड नाउ दे आर एंटरिंग इन द रिमोट डीप एरिया ऑफ सिंघू बॉर्डर इमेजिन दिस कुड बी रियली अ फ्लैश पॉइंट ऑफ व्हाट हैज हैपेंड ऑन द रिपब्लिक डे कुड बी अनदर यू नो ब्रॉल बिटवीन टू ग्रुप्स So here they were allowed to march in this particular area.
The farmers hit back, saying they won't be intimidated. Caught in the crossfire, the police had a tough time keeping things under control. In Rewari too, there were tense scenes as locals demanded that the protest site be vacated. While the agitation continues, the protesters are thinning out. Heat is mounting on farmer leaders over the Republic Day mayhem. So far, 37 farmer leaders have been named in the FIR. The leaders have been given 3 days to reply why legal action should not be initiated against them for the January 26th violence. At the Tikri border, heavy police force is visible. Fresh reinforcements have been rushed in and new barricades erected.
You can see the barricades and now the police has isolated this area and no civilian movement is allowed. About a kilometer from here, the agitating farmers are sitting and now the police is not allowing any civilian to enter through this area.
Meanwhile, the Delhi-Noida link road is now fully open. With the Bharat Kisan Union, Bhanu faction ending its protest, Chilla border is cleared of protesters after nearly 2 months. In Uttar Pradesh, the police have begun crackdown on protests. They have vacated the protest site in Baghpat. The state has asked its district administrations to bring all protest to an end. With Abhishek Anand and Ashutosh Mishra, Bureau Report, India Today.
And we've got some news just in. Quick reminder that Punjab Chief Minister Amrinder Singh, seen by many to have been the person who actually began or triggered the protests in the first place, has slammed the government's lookout notices against the farmer union leaders, saying that they are not Vijay Mallya or Nirav Modi or Mehul Choksi, but small farmers. So where will they flee? So Amrinder Singh, the Chief Minister of Punjab, has now had his say as well. Okay, I want to go across to former Delhi Police Commissioner T.R. Kakkar. We also have with us Avneet Pamar, who is Rashtriya Adhyaksh Kisan Sena chief, who's joining us. He's a farmer union leader. Mr. Kakkar, coming to you first, there is an ultimatum that has been issued by the government in UP for the Ghazipur border, for instance, to be vacated by midnight tonight. You know, this could be a troublesome situation, sir, because Rakesh Tikait has said he's not going to move. He's sitting on a hunger strike. How is this to be handled?
Before I answer you this question, let me place on record the utmost restraint shown by Delhi police and other paramilitary forces for all these days, and especially on the 26th again. Now, coming to your question of an ultimatum or telling the agitators to vacate by tonight or by tomorrow morning, it is the right of the state to do that, because they have done it after almost 62 days. And this has been done because of the inability of these leaders to control those rowdies, Khalistanis, Atankwadis, and all sorts of troubleshooters who defile the our symbol of nation, that is the red fort and hoisted some other flag. Now, this is being done today. I heard Mr. Tikait in, and I know Tikait personally because he belongs to us. Now, he has been telling those people very openly in his videos that you carry dandas and carry the tiranga also. And you know what danda, you know, and he's giving them an indication. It's very clear. Similarly, all other leaders, while they were professing peace, they were trying to instigate people and making them ready. Otherwise, tell me, why at Singhu border do we need the Nihang on the horseback? Are they coming to take over Delhi? Why didn't they send them back? And some of the Nihangs have been seen now using kripans, using bhalas on the policemen.
Yes.
Now this is no peaceful agitation. Let me tell you, today I heard Tikait to say that if he is forced, he'll commit suicide. He will not commit suicide. Because there's too much at stake for him everywhere.
Okay.
So he will not commit suicide.
Mr. Kakkar, stay with me. Mr. Kakkar, stay with me. I want to get in a word also from...
Now that cases have been registered, the law will take its course.
Okay.
Whether Mr. Amrinder Singh or Mr. Rahul Gandhi threatens that there will be aag lag jayegi pure desh mein. Lagne do bhai.
No, I mean...
Lagne lagwaye aap. Aap lagwaye na.
Rahul Gandhi is a separate issue altogether. Avneet Pamar is also a Kisan leader. He's a... of the Rashtriya Adhyaksh Kisan Sena. He's the Kisan Sena. Avneet ji, kya aapko lagta hai ki ye jo protest jo 2 mahine se jari tha, Republic Day pe jo hinsa hua tha, uske baad jo aaj jo investigation shuru hua hai, Rakesh Tikait ne jo bola hai, aapne suna hoga, iske baad kya aapko lagta hai ki ye jo pradarshan tha, jo protest tha, ye khatam hone ja raha hai?
देखिए, पहले तो मैं ये बताना चाहूंगा कि प्रोटेस्ट में देश के किसान इन्वॉल्व थे, ना कि राकेश टिकैत इन्वॉल्व थे. राकेश टिकैत एक संगठन चला रहे हैं, वो अपनी बात आपके माध्यम से देश के सामने रखते हैं, वो अपने विचार रखते हैं. कुछ चीजें होती है जो संयुक्त तौर पे रखी जाती है. अगर किसान की बात करें तो किसानों का आंदोलन खत्म नहीं होगा, किसान अपना आंदोलन करते रहेंगे.
रिपब्लिक डे के बाद भी जो हुआ था उस दिन,
मैं जानता हूं उस दिन जो हुआ वो गलत हुआ, उसके ये चीजें नहीं होनी चाहिए थी. देश का सम्मान जहां भी आएगा किसान अपने आप झुकेगा. लेकिन किसानों की भी बात रखी जानी चाहिए थी। अगर हम बात करें, सरकार ने हमें लास्ट मीटिंग में ये कह दिया कि आगे की कोई डेट तय नहीं, आप बताइए, लेकिन इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि जो हुआ हुआ अच्छा किया या जिसने भी किया।
लेकिन अवनीत जी, रिपब्लिक डे पे जो हुआ था उसके बाद क्या आपको लगता है कि आप किसान के संगठन के पास कुछ लेवरेज है, कुछ क्रेडिबिलिटी है नेगोशिएट या बात करने के लिए? क्योंकि इसके पहले तो सारे जो टॉक्स के राउंड्स थे आप बिल्कुल अडिग थे, आप बिल्कुल हिलने वाले नहीं थे आपके डिमांड से। और क्या आपको लगता है कि रिपब्लिक डे के हिंसा के बाद कुछ भी है आपके पास, आपके हाथ में बात करने के लिए?
देखिए, मैं आपको ये जानकारी दूं कि बात करने के लिए कुछ लोग अगर गलत हैं तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि पूरे देश के किसान गलत हैं। पूरे देश का किसान आंदोलन में बैठा है, हर अपने तरीके से सब आंदोलन में भाग ले रहे हैं, कोई
भूख
हड़ताल करके बैठे, इसमें बहुत सारे किसान इन्वॉल्व भी हैं, किसान संगठन इन्वॉल्व। लेकिन अगर दो या तीन संगठन जो गलत हैं, जिनकी वजह से आंदोलन को नीचे देखना पड़ रहा है, तो मैं चाहूंगा सरकार उन लोगों को छांटे और इस आंदोलन से अलग करे, क्योंकि किसान सिर्फ उन तीन बिलों की बात कर रहा है। हिंसा में विश्वास किसान नहीं रखता है, शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से इस ठंड में।
नूपुर, यू वांट टू आंसर दैट? नूपुर, यू वांट टू आंसर अवनीत?
वेल, आई कंप्लीटली डिसएग्री दैट पूरे देश का किसान यहां पे बैठा हुआ है, बिकॉज फ्रॉम व्हाट, इवन इफ दे ट्राई टू डू अ हेड काउंट, ऑल 16 अप्रोक्सीमेटली 16 करोड़ फार्मर्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री वर नॉट एक्चुअली इन दिस प्रोटेस्ट। बट यू नो, आई एक्चुअली वांट टू कम बैक बाय आंसरिंग हिज क्वेश्चन एंड ऑल्सो द कांग्रेस स्पोक्सपर्सन।
फर्स्ट हिज क्वेश्चन, देन द कांग्रेस।
लॉज आर नॉट लेजिस्लेटेड, और डिसीजंस ऑन लेजिस्लेशन ऑफ लॉज इज नॉट टेकन, decision on legislation of laws is not taken on streets. This is not a banana republic. If a law has been passed by the parliament, let the court handle its veracity, legal veracity as for the constitution of India, but laws or any decision thereof will be taken within the parliament and the supreme court of India. Now, having said that, Congress sounds like a confused outfit. From condemning the events of 26 January to today, Captain Amrinder Singh saying that lookout notices should not have been issued, to sometimes, I'm sorry to say, saying, oh, the protests were peaceful. Then what were Ravinder Bittu, who's the member of parliament from Congress party, and Gursimran Singh Mann, who's a senior Kisan Congress leader, saying when the Khalistanis have infested? Are Khalistanis peaceful now? That these people for the past 3-4 months have been saying Khalistanis are infested, and that's why the NIA please seem to keep him. Otherwise, the remaining part of the debate will become a heckling match.
No, Abdi ji, one second. Let her finish. I'll come back to you. I'll come back to you if I have time.
No, I think the Congress party really needs to take a call on what.
Okay, so since you're asking a direct question of the Congress party, let's get Supriya in on this. You're right, because we've just had Amrinder Singh say, why are you going after small farmers who are protesting, lookout notice. I mean, this is a part of the investigation. How else will you know who's responsible for what happened, Supriya?
Fair point indeed, but what amuses me is that the BJP spokesperson just said decisions are made by parliament and legislations are passed there. The kind of ordinances that you've got on major reforms in this country, one would not believe that you either respect parliament or parliamentary procedures. And since I have been saying from day one, if you really are large-hearted and if you really want to find a way out of this, as a Congress person, as an Indian, and as the daughter of a farmer, I would like to turn around and say, you know what, be large-hearted, get another ordinance, because
no, but I, this talks have been happening, peaceful talks have been happening. I don't get it. I mean,
I did not know ordinances were ultra-virus the Constitution. Before this debate, I did not know ordinances were ultra-virus the Constitution.
I can understand what you're saying, Supriya, if there were no talks happening. There were talks happening.
I did not know that.
This violence has happened after 9 rounds of talks.
I happen to be from a farmer's family. I did not know you and I have the wherewithal to decide amongst us and to usurp the adjudicatory power of the Honorable Supreme Court of India and decide amongst us on Indian 8 p.m. debate whether what procedure is parliamentary or not, or constitutional or not. This is hilarious. This is hilarious. This is the best.
But it's a little late. Supriya, if you allow me, it would be what you're saying about the government would be legitimate if there were no talks happening. There were talks happening at every round. After the last round of talks, the government said it would suspend those laws and not enforce them for 18 months. I mean, this was the I hold no brief. I am just saying that there were constructive talks that were happening, and this violence has happened after 9 rounds of talks. It's not like the government was not moving. It's the farmer groups who were not moving, and then this violence has happened.
11 rounds of talks, and all those attempts were to fire the farmers.
Okay.
Including suspension.
No, that's that's just politics.
The Prime Minister gave a word that he will put 15 lakh rupees in every account. Did he? The Prime Minister gave a word he will create 2 crore jobs every year. Did he?
Now you're just firing in every direction. I mean, come on. Supriya, okay. I'm out of time now.
The farmers are saying it is the law. Why don't you do that? That's simple.
I'm out of time now. Okay.
Okay.
I'm completely out of time. Nupur and Supriya, I'm completely out of time. I tried not to get the both of you to talk over each other, but that's the way it is. This is still a developing story. I just want to tell all of our viewers, this is, I know we've been talking about some of the other things, but this is still a developing story. Nupur, Supriya, Avneet ji, Mr. Kakkar, thank you very much for joining me.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.